I've walked among the shadows, you wiped my tears away, and I felt the pain of heartbreak, and I've seen the brighter days, and I've prayed prayers to heaven from my lowest place, and I have held your blessings, God, you give and take away. No matter what I have, your grace is enough. No matter where I am, I'm standing in your love. On the mountains, I will bow my life to the one who set me there. In the valley, I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there. When I'm standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, I know I am not alone. You're God of the hills and valleys, and I am not alone. I've watched my dreams get broken, in you I hope again. No matter what, I know I'm safe inside your hands. On the mountains I will bow my life to the one who set me there. In the valley, I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there. When I'm standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, I know I am not alone. You're God of the hills and valleys, hills and valleys, God of the hills and valleys.
Good evening, ladies. It is so awesome to have you back yes. in the house and online for Women's Bible Study. I'm Anissa Anderson.
And I'm Denisha Martinez.
Welcome. If this is your first time joining us here on our Plano campus or OC Global, OCC Global in the house, we want to say welcome. Thank you for joining us for Women's Bible Study, ladies. We've been missing having our time together to be able to connect.
Girl, I'm so excited to be here. I got overdressed. I'm so happy to be in the house. I am overdressed today.
And see, y'all can't see the full dress online, but in person, y'all can see the full dress with the stiletto boots. Listen, she came ready.
Right.
So, ladies, if it is your first time and you are in person, make sure you scan the QR code that's behind your seats. You can also online text in our number. It is 469-609-1909. Text hello. We want to give you a warm welcome as well. So thank you for joining us. If you have any prayer requests, please put your prayer requests in the chats. We want to make sure that we cover you in prayer on tonight. Our prayer team, they are ready to pray for you and with you.
Yes.
Let's see. Denisha?
We are still doing 40 Days of Reading.
We are.
So it's so funny. I was talking to Anissa in the back. I was like, I thought we were done with that already. But we are not. Because that is so important to us as a church, we want to make sure that we continue spending time with God each and every day. So we are reading closer. And Anissa, you have a little bit more details on that. You want to tell them?
Yeah. So we are reading our closer reading plan. I know that some of us may not have remembered that we were back at it, but we got such a huge response. And so this is a time, it's a devotional.
It is.
And so in this devotional, we have where you can take notes and you can print it up online. Also, just go to our website, visit 1cc.com to get that source. And you can also, there's prayer that's a part of it. And then there's scripture. There's books of the Bible that we're reading together as a church family. And so if you haven't jumped in, don't feel like, oh my goodness, I missed the first 40 days. It is too late. Just jump in where we are right now. We love for you to be a part of that with us. That's what we're going over in the mornings during prayer time too. So some of the talks that our pastors, our staff, that they're giving is based off of that.
So we're pulling it through.
Yep.
And I love the fact that you said that as a family, we are a church family. And if you are interested in becoming a partner with us, we would love for you to join our family. We actually have new membership classes this Sunday. March 6th, they're in person and virtual. There's a lot of times it's available because we want to make it as easy for you to attend in person or virtual as possible. So go online, check out us, check us out at That's how you know I'm old, right? Because I said www.visit1cc.com.
I hope everybody knows that www. But you know what? You know that.
But just in case you didn't know it, I was the first one to tell you. But we would love for you to join us for one of our membership classes coming up. And speaking of classes, Now if you are single and you're interested in engaging with other singles, we have pain-free dating coming up, and we would love for you to join us. This session is about healing wounds of past relationships.
Yeah, yeah.
And you know, I knew you when you were single.
Oh, you know what? We knew each other when we were single.
Back in the day.
Back in the day.
And you need to heal so that you can actually move on to Absolutely. The next thing that God has for you.
Absolutely. Especially if you have had previous dating experience and things of that nature. Yes. There's some healing for sure that needs to take place, or something that you saw broken in the household yes. growing up. So definitely, ladies, join and tell the guys too, because this is for guys.
It's for
and,
everybody. Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yep. That's March 17th. You have to register online. Make sure you do that, because you'll get a Zoom link for those classes, because that is online only on Zoom.
All right.
So definitely do that. And then for the couples,
right.
let's not forget about it. So we are in that stage.
Everybody. Yes.
We're in that stage now. That's so funny. Different seasons of life that we have been a part of together.
That's before we said www, by the way.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes. Yeah. So that is Pillow Talk. It is the same day, Thursday, March 17th. You want to register for that as well if you are married. That topic is uprooting bitterness in your marriage, y'all. Yeah. That is huge, because yeah. that root just continues to grow if you do not get rid of it, right? It spreads. And so you want to hear more about that topic. Make sure that you register. That's a Zoom link also that you will receive. So make sure that you take care of that, go into our website.
And Super Bowl mm-hmm. Sunday is coming up for the church, also known as Easter. We do Easter
yes.
big around here, because that is a great opportunity to bring the non-church, the non-believer into the church.
Mm-hmm.
So we need your help. I cannot stress this enough. We need your help.
Absolutely.
So our ask of you is that you choose to serve at one and attend one. It's
mm-hmm.
a great opportunity to engage with the ministry. You're not mm-hmm. that sure of a great opportunity to check that out, but also more importantly, an opportunity to serve others. We
yeah.
celebrate Easter because Christ sacrificed it for us. And so
right.
we ask that you give up a couple hours on your
right.
Sunday to serve someone else Easter weekend.
Denisha, I love that. It is so about sacrificial giving, right? Of your time, your energy. And just like you said, Christ modeled that.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
And so models it still. So I love that. Please make sure that you sign up to serve, volunteer. There's so many opportunities, so many areas to get connected and get involved. And you don't have to wait till Easter.
You do not.
Wait a minute. We got like 6 weeks.
Right.
So you can sign up to serve in your area now yes. that you're planning on serving in for Easter. So we encourage you to do that. Once again, if this is your first time joining us, make sure that you put that in the chat. We want to make sure we give you a warm welcome. If you have any prayer requests, do that as well. Welcome to Women's Bible Study.
Yes.
I'm Anissa Anderson.
And I'm Denisha Martinez. You know, tonight is all about women, but guess what? Next week, it's all about the men.
It's men church. It is.
Go ahead on.
Listen, so ladies, I'm assuming that there might be a few men watching too, but if there's not, make sure you tell your brothers, cousins, any men in your life, invite them to Man Church. It is in person, Plano campus also, 7 o'clock. That starts next week.
Mm-hmm.
And so, well, they actually had one before that, but this will be their second one on next week. So make sure that they come to Man Church so they can be equipped to lead.
And lead well.
Right.
There's something else coming up. So we talked about things for the women. We talked about serving. We talked
mm-hmm.
about Man Church. Now mm-hmm. let's spend a little time talking about our kiddos.
Oh, yes.
We have Crew coming
mm-hmm.
up, which is a middle school version of Awana as well as Awana.
Mm-hmm.
So we actually have something from kids from kindergarten all the way
yep.
on up to high school. So if you are here mm-hmm. tonight, if your man is here next week for Man Church,
mm-hmm.
what a great opportunity for your children to come and spend time and grow in the Word.
And so the Crew and Awana are on Wednesday nights.
They are.
So you definitely can bring your kids for those. And then we have, for our teenagers, something else is coming up, y'all. For most of our kids, it'll be spring break next weekend. And so a part of that spring break at the end, Thursday and Friday, Saturday, March 10th through the 12th, is the weekend.
What?
And so some of our, not some of our students, all the students that I've talked to.
And not the artists the weekend.
No, it's not the artist the right, weekend. Yes. It is called the weekend because we're trying to make sure that we are relevant with our teenagers.
Yes.
So we got to try to still be cool, right? And say it cool.
Right.
And so it is called the weekend. Make sure that you register your teenagers for the weekend retreats. They are actively engaged with teaching at their level, worship as well. And so we don't want them to miss out. So ladies, we have worship that we want you to be a part of and join us.
Yes, so, but there's one other thing we want to do.
Giving challenge.
There you go.
Oh, you know what? I wanted to make sure when we talked about sacrificial time of energy, I also just want to say thank you because so many of you have given sacrificially already. We have the student building up. We have our Garland campus that has already launched, y'all. So we just want to say thank you to all of you. The ladies in the house, you probably can hear them. OC Global, thank you.
Yes.
And if you want to join in our giving challenge, make sure you go to our website, visit 1cc.com, and you can give one time, you can give multiple times. We'd love to have you do that. I'm sure right now, you can see behind us some ladies. Get ready to worship with us. Stand up.
it still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands.
This is
my confidence. You never fail.
Say your promise still stands, yeah.
Great is your faithfulness.
He's been faithful.
I'm
still in your hands, yeah.
This is my confidence. You never fail me, yeah.
We serve a God who will never fail us. No. You never fail us, yeah. Oh, we always win because we're victorious in you, Lord.
I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Yes, I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Yeah.
The weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. And when the darkness falls, it won't prevail. The God I serve knows only how to triumph. And my God will never fail. No, my God will never fail.
I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory.
We can declare that today.
For the
because the battle belongs to the Lord.
Belongs to you, Lord.
I'm gonna see a victory.
I'm gonna see a victory.
Yeah.
I'm gonna see a victory.
For the battle.
For the
it belongs
battle
to the Lord.
Belongs to you, Lord.
It belongs.
You turn it for good.
He's turning it. turn it for good.
To know that he's got us, that the battle belongs to him, and what the enemy says is not true.
It does not matter. It does not matter.
It doesn't matter. It's false. And we know that in our heart. We know that in our mind, ladies. So I encourage you, when you feel like the battle is yours, know that that is false. Fall to your knees, submit that to the Lord, because the enemy is trying to trick you, ladies. We are so glad that you have joined us for Women's Bible Study for spring semester.
Yes,
thank
yes.
you so much for joining us. OCC Global, thank you for joining us online as well. If this is your first time ever coming to a Women's Bible Study, y'all, we want to make sure that we give you a warm welcome. We want to make sure that you scan that QR code on the back of your chair. OCC Global, make sure that you text in hello to 469-609-1909 as well. We don't want to miss out on saying hello to you, to connect with you,
yes.
and hopefully connect you with other ladies who are walking this walk with the Lord as well. Right?
You know, during the last 2 years, there have been so many people that have been visiting. Right, they have been
yep.
looking at our church and wondering whether or not they wanted to become a part of this. And I will actually tell you, you do. God is doing
yep.
something here that I guarantee that you want to be a part of. So if you've been thinking about whether or not you want to partner with us, I would encourage you to do so. We actually have a partnership class that's happening on this Sunday.
We sure do.
There are classes that are going to be in person. There are classes that are going to be online. But ladies, we're in a new year. It's time for no more excuses. So I'm asking that you get off the sidelines and make your way into the game. We would love to have you partner with
amen,
us.
Amen, amen. Join in. So membership class, it is this Saturday and Sunday. Well, actually, Sunday, 2 o'clock p.m., virtual or in person. So you actually don't have an excuse whatsoever. And you'll get to hear about the heartbeat of our church. The reason why we say no one walks alone.
Nobody.
And we believe no one walks alone. And so make sure that you get connected and join in on our membership class on this Sunday. And then also, Easter. Y'all, it's like 6 weeks away. I cannot believe Easter is right around the corner, and we don't want you to miss out on an opportunity to volunteer.
Yes.
And so that you can go ahead and go online, go to visit1cc.com. If you are not volunteering, you're not serving anywhere, we encourage you to get online on our website, sign up. There are so many opportunities, so many different ministries that you can be a part of. So we encourage you to volunteer, and you can sign up today.
Yes.
And y'all can volunteer starting this weekend. And then you can decide, is that the ministry that God has called me to serve in?
I love it.
Right?
I love it.
Yeah.
And just like for Easter, you prepare what you're going to cook on Easter Sunday. You prepare what you're going to wear
Easter
Sunday.
You know, if you're having a honey back ham.
Right.
You already
But you
got
to order early and get there early to pick up, right?
Right.
We also want you to think through, where are you going to serve? So please serve once at Anesis Point and attend one. And as much as service is a part of what we do, we also want you to grow. So there's some classes coming up that you definitely want to attend.
Yep.
One of which is called Pain-Free Dating. And that's happening on March 17th. And I love the title of this.
I know. Pain-free dating, of course, is for our singles.
Thank you, because that's critically important.
Right.
It is
even though we couples should be dating.
Right.
But
if you have a single friend,
else.
They should join this class. And this one's called Healing from Past Wounds.
Mm-hmm.
Healing from Past Wounds.
Yeah.
So this is one of many classes that we have going on. We have Pillow Talk coming
Pillow
up.
Pillow Talk is for our
same
couples.
Same day as well.
March 17th. Thursday, March 17th, don't miss out on our Pillow Talk or Pain-Free Dating, depending on what season you are in. You want to register because you'll get a Zoom link for that, because it is Zoom only. But they are very engaging classes. People are able to ask questions, and we're teaching on that particular topic. So ladies, don't miss out. We are going to close, and we're going to actually go to a video right now. So turn your eyes to the screen, and we will see you hopefully this weekend also.
Absolutely.
For church service.
Sounds good. Thanks, ladies.
Ladies, it is my favorite time of year. Yes, we had kind of a delayed start this year, but we are ready to jump back into women's Bible study. I hear you. Yes, because we love studying the Word of God. And this semester, I cannot wait to share with you some of my favorite Bible teachers. So we're going to have amazing guests each week. And guess what? I get to learn with you. I'm so excited to get to sit and study God's Word alongside you. I guarantee you that every message is going to bless you, it's going to enrich you, it's going to equip you. So stay tuned, invite friends. You're going to be exposed to some great new teachers this semester, but they are all already killing it in the game. So I can't wait for you to join me this semester for Women's Bible Study. Let's learn together.
See, all right, here we go. I'm sorry about that. But y'all ready for a good night tonight? Now, let me tell y'all who's coming up. The Reverend Jaqueline Thompson. Now, let me tell you about this woman. If y'all have not heard her teach, you are in for a treat. And I'm not even exaggerating. It's like having your girlfriend and your auntie come and teach God's word to you all wrapped up in one person. She keeps it real, she keeps it authentic, and she follows the truth that's in God's word. So if you came tonight to be cute, kind of like I did because you were excited, this ain't what you're looking for tonight. I would encourage you to sit back and relax and take in the word that she has for you. I'm going to get on off this stage real quick to bring her on up. But if you don't mind, can I pray for her real quick before she comes to the stage? Father God, thank you for this woman who is beautiful on the inside and out. Thank you for the gift that you've given her of speaking your word and speaking it clearly and boldly. Lord, I pray that whatever is on her heart and mind right now that keeps her from presenting the word the way that you would want to, that you would remove any and every distraction. Give her a fresh anointing as she walks up here today. And Lord, I pray that you give her a fresh word as she gives her the word that you've given her to us. It's in Jesus' name that we have the privilege of praying. Amen.
What? I need to know if you're here tonight. It's all right. Some of you don't know me. Take a minute. Check me out. It's all right. But I need to know if you're here tonight. This is my first time at a woman's Bible study, so I'm excited to be here with you all. And I really, for those of you who know me, know right now I want to sing Brian McKnight so bad. But y'all haven't remixed it yet, so I can't do my Brian McKnight. But it is good to be in the house of the Lord. It is good to be alive. It is good to be back with you, Juan. And to all of you who are viewing us online, of course, it is so good to have you back as well. And I'm certainly grateful to Jada for thinking of me to come and share with you. Her and Pastor Conway, we know they're watching, right? Even though they're supposed to be on vacation. I promise you, they are watching. So just say, we love you. And we do love you. I promise you I'm going to be on time because y'all know they got timers and stuff. And so I'm the speaker that goes off time. But if y'all pray, we're going to be on time and you'll be able to get to your small groups in person and virtually. But I just want to give you an update. It's been a while since I've been here, maybe 2019, right? We've been shut down for 2 years. So I just want to give you an update on what's been going on with me. So the last time I was here, I think it might have been for the Climb Conference. That would have been in 2019. And so I went back home, and little did I know that life was going to hit, because life just hits. And so December 1st, 2019, I lost this guy, my dad. I didn't know it. I don't know. That's my dad. Reverend Dr. M.T. Thompson. And so, y'all, he thought his son was going to be the preacher, but it's me. December 1st, 2019, and literally maybe 7 days later, then this church in California picked me to be their leader, like the first woman in 100 years. And so then I had this service. And it was an installation. They installed me, and it was a big celebration, literally a roller coaster. I had a low on Sunday, and then the following Sunday, there's this huge high, right? And so we go along, Kobe dies, and we should have known then when Kobe died that something was gonna happen, right? Him and his daughter, we had a whole shutdown, went through the shutdown, God was still good, and then November 21, this lady, I moved back to California to take care of her. That's my mom. Her real name is Easter, like Easter Sunday. And if you called her Esther, she would have a whole attitude. That was not her name. She was not trying to be Queen Esther. She was trying to be Easter, like Resurrection Sunday. And so November 21, she passed. That was another low, right? But here's why I shared it, not to depress you, not to make you say, oh, or ah, but guess what? I'm still here. And I share it because you are sitting on the row next to somebody that if you were to look at them, just look at them and say, you just don't know. Turn around, tell you have no idea, but tell them I'm still here, that the enemy tried it. If that's not you, I'm not talking to you, but I know a few ladies that can stand on their feet and say the enemy tried it. And I know some women that are not even here anymore, but tell somebody I'm still here. I may not have what I used to have, but I'm still here. And there are some women that can say, God bless me, even in the middle of a pandemic, I came out better. I need somebody to help me shift the atmosphere. I came back better than I was before I ever went in the pandemic in the first place. I'm still here. And if we still here, we might as well give God glory. We might as well say thank you. We might as well say thank you for still keeping us in spite of us, for protecting us, for providing for us. Come on, I know it's somebody in the chat that can type, I'm still here. Because life is full of ups and downs. And in case y'all didn't know, I started. It's full of roller coaster type experiences where one day you feel like you're sitting on top of the world, and then the next day it feels like everything is falling apart. And the cold part is we look good. So people don't think anything is going on. You're still managing, you're still mothering, you're still being wives, you're still working, but little do people know you're doing everything you can to hang on and still reflect Jesus. So I prayed and asked God what he would have me share with you tonight. And I tried to figure out, I want to be in order. You know, what have they been working on? What was last year? Okay, why church matters? The book of Acts? Okay. God said, no. I said, oh, okay, great. Well, what you want to do, Lord? So we're going to walk through a text because I think the message I want you to take away tonight for this first kickoff for Women's Bible Study is stay connected. Tell a sister next to you, say, do whatever it takes. She don't even have to know what you're talking about. And if she don't talk, she the wrong one. Turn around, find somebody with a mask on. Say, do whatever it takes. If you don't have no goals, no ambitions, it's all right. But somebody say, do whatever it takes. We are in the Gospel of Mark tonight. So if you have your paper Bibles, or if you have your phones, or if you have your iPads, those of you, we're going to have it in here. We're in the Gospel of Mark, Mark chapter 2. We're going to walk the text, and hopefully we'll go share some lessons, share some questions, some things for you to ponder. It's a familiar text. I know you all know it, but we believe the Holy Spirit can do something new. Is that all right? All right, so the Gospel of Mark, one of four Gospels. You all know this because you are members of one community church. And y'all do Bible. You know it's four Gospels. Mark is one of the Gospels. Mark is believed to be the earliest Gospel that is written as a reflection of the life and the ministry of Jesus. Mark was specific. He had a specific goal in mind. He wanted you to start at the first chapter, go all the way through the end of the chapter, close the book, and say, Jesus is certainly a servant of God. That was his mindset. He wanted you to see Jesus as a suffering servant. And so they say he was a contemporary of Peter, that him and Peter were friends. And so Peter would tell him about what it was like to live and minister and walk with Jesus, and John Mark wrote it down. And so what we have here is an amalgamation of specific stories that have been pulled out and strategically placed to get you from one place to another. So in Mark chapter 1, that's why Mark doesn't start with Mary. And he doesn't start with the birth, because he's not worried about any of that. He's not like Matthew. He's not worried about genealogy. I kind of like it because it means it doesn't matter who I was born to or who I was connected to or what side of the track I grew up on or if I live in Prosper or if I live in Oak Cliff. It really don't matter. That as long as God's hand is on my life, that God can still use me to do something great. So Mark starts. Don't start with genealogy. Don't matter where you come from. He starts with ministry. So when you're in Mark chapter 1, you get John the Baptist in the baptism, right? So Jesus comes out of the water. This is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. Boom, Jesus in ministry. So it says he goes, he's ministering, he's in Capernaum. He preaches and he teaches, he heals, he delivers, he casts out devils. But he does it so much that he has to take a break, because it says the people were crowding him and they brought people from all over the area. Because the one thing that we don't tell the truth about is even though we love God and even though we want to worship God, we get tired. I need to talk to real women in the house. We get tired trying to be every woman. It's all in us. No, I don't want it all in me. Can you take some? Noah Shaka talking about, give it to Whitney. Give it to some. Give Rihanna some. Give Beyonce some. It ain't all got to be in me. He got tired, so it said he went away to Galilee. And he started preaching and ministering there. So at the beginning of chapter 2, here we are with Jesus returning back to Capernaum. So the scripture says a few days later, when Jesus again entered Capernaum, the people heard that he had come home. All right? Verse 2. They gathered in such large numbers that there was no room left. Y'all know about that, Edwin. It said no room on the outside, no room by the door. And Jesus started preaching to them the word. It messed some of them up because they didn't really prefer the preaching Jesus. They wanted the miracle working Jesus. Because you do know sometimes we struggle because we want the miracle, but we don't want the message. And oftentimes the thing that's delaying your miracle is that you don't want to receive the message. That you wouldn't need God to keep delivering you out the relationship if you would just receive the message that he ain't the one. Pull out your phone, delete the number now. We won't tell nobody. Screenshot it, send it to your girl. Say, Pastor Jackie made me do it. But Jesus doesn't perform miracles yet. He starts preaching. And then the scripture says that some men came. Y'all don't mind if we talk about men at the women's Bible study. Is it all right? Because, you know, I talk about women in front of the men, so they'll be all right. They brought to him a paralyzed man carried by four of them. The text goes on. I'll read it through, and then we'll work our way back. Since they could not get him to Jesus because of the crowd, they made an opening in the roof above, digging through it, and then they lowered the mat that the man was laying on. Verse 5, we're going through. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralyzed man, "Son, your sins are forgiven." But some of the teachers of the law, church folk, not nobody here, that other church that I, they were sitting there thinking to themselves, why does he talk like that? He's blaspheming. Who can forgive sins alone but God? But immediately Jesus knew in his spirit that this was what they were thinking in their hearts. That's why you got to watch what you're thinking. Because some of us got discernment. And we know even though you're smiling at us, you don't like us. Why are you thinking these things? He said to them, verse 9. Which is easier, to say, paralyzed man, your sins are forgiven, or to say, get up, take your mat, and walk? This is gangster Jesus right here. But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority. Didn't y'all talk about that? And why church matters, authority on earth to forgive sins. So he said to the man, he said, I tell you, take up your mat and go home. He got up, took his mat, walked out in full view of them all. This amazed everyone. And they praised God, saying, we've never seen anything like this. Here is what messed me up in the text. The scripture says they are in woman's Bible study. My scripture. It is packed to capacity. And all of a sudden, while Jesus is preaching, the roof starts falling. Different parts of the light start falling. Because there was somebody that had a need. And the place was so crowded that the people that actually needed to get to Jesus couldn't get to Jesus. And we have to make sure in the crowd of our lives that we are not hindering people from actually getting to Jesus. Because sometimes we think to have a lot is to be significant. But here's the thing. In every crowd, you always have different kinds of people. In every crowd, you always have critics. In every crowd, you always have complainers. In every crowd, there's always somebody that's crippled. In every crowd, hopefully if it's your crowd, Christ is somewhere in the crowd. And then there is always somebody who is a carrier, who's designed to help you get from one place to the next. So the Bible says there's a paralyzed man and he can't get anywhere except for who he's connected to. And sometimes, ladies, we can't get to where God wants us to be, not because of us, but because of who we remain. That's why you have to make sure you stay connected to the right folks. Stay connected to the right church. Stay connected to the right ministry. Stay connected to God. Because the only way he was going to make it to the feet of Jesus is he needed somebody that thought the way he thought to make sure that he was actually going to get there. So I said, Lord, what is it going to take? What is required for us to actually stay connected, especially if you're the one that's standing, it's okay. But is there anybody honest enough to say sometimes I feel paralyzed? That just the stressors in life, I want to move, but I can't move. Sometimes I think I'm moving and I look up and I haven't moved at all. Sometimes, even in that position, your prayer is, God, send me some people. That's why we come to Women's Bible Study. So you can look around the room and see you're not in it by yourself. That's why we continue to come to church, so that we can be encouraged just to know that there is somebody that's dealing with something similar to what I'm dealing with. But if you have people in your space who are not committed to your walk, people in your space who are not committed to your growth, people in your space who say, why are you running down there all the time to that church? You there all the time, and then they just got up talking about serve, and then don't serve. Actually, on Easter, practice serve before you serve. The scripture says they dug through the roof, lowered the man on the mat, in front of Jesus. I need five men. Is it five men here? I need brothers. And one sister, maybe. One sister. Is it men anywhere? If it ain't no men, we gonna use some women. But I saw three. I did see three. Maybe they not supposed to be here. They working equipment, so they not supposed to be here. All right, I won't get the men in trouble. I need five women then. Give me five women. Volunteers. All right, come on, sweetie. Bless you. Come on. Bless you. I knew they was here. Stop playing with me. Where the drummer? And the bass player, guitar player. We might get an illustration out of this. Hold on, ladies, hold on. Because I knew they was in the building. But I want to show you. I want to show you because sometimes we need a visual for what God is actually trying to do. So we're gonna see if they come. And if they take 2 minutes longer, we're going to have to work this out without it. Where they at? Okay, Marvin, they taking a little long. Come on, ladies. One, two, three. I need two more. Bless you. All right. Bless you. I got my two. All right. I saw you in the back. She was ready to come, too. Come on, just because you was ready. That's what I'm talking about. We at the Women's Bible Study. Right? Okay. And so since she came, this is what I'm going to need. Come on. And you got tennis shoes on. Good. And you ran because you limbo. So come here. Don't call me crazy. Come here. I need you to lay down right there. On your back. Look at you. It's all right. This new for one. Because here's the reality of the matter. Sometimes there are things we experience that lay you out just like that. The only difference is we still cooking. We still cleaning. We still taking kids to school. We're still showing up. But on the insides, our spirits are laid out. And we lift our hands still. And we sing and we worship still. But if we are honest about it, on the inside, we look just like this. Let me tell you why connection is so important. Because she laying here by herself can't do anything for herself. But she has some onlookers. She has some other folk that she's been in relationship with, right? And they are not so haughty to say, oh, I have never been laid out like that. Because you can't be connected to people who don't understand where you've been. Because if you don't understand where I've been, then I can't trust that you're going to believe where God is actually trying to take me. So sometimes you got to be connected to folks who know you. So she's connected to some people who look and say, this ain't how this is supposed to be. What are we going to do? But sometimes we have people in our space who say, hey, how you doing today? Okay, good. All right, I'll be back tomorrow. Do you need anything? They're not worried about your condition at all. Nothing in them says this is not supposed to be this way. But he had four people who were carriers. And carriers are designed to take you from one place to the next place. He's connected to people who say, you know what? I heard Jesus was back in the building. And then the other person said, well, you know, Jesus can heal anybody. So if we can just get him to Jesus, then maybe the situation can change. Here's one of the ways you stay connected. Stay connected to vision. Because here is where we mess up. Sometimes we are engaging people who can't see us any differently than just like this. They're only comfortable when you're just like this. They only know who they are in relation to who you are when you're just like this. Which is why when you start to change and you start to transform and you start to walk in the word, the people who you thought would understand and support you are the main ones that start acting funny with you, because they only knew who they were when you were down. But why can't we all be up? When it's up, it's stuck. So the Bible says, they get her to Jesus. Now, I'm going to let y'all figure it out. You come with me. Mm-hmm. So now, this was what got to happen. All right. So now, she here, but Jesus over there. And so, they got to figure out how they going to get her to Jesus. Now, we going to let them do it. Hold on. Okay. How'd you... I don't know how they're going to do it. Because one of them is saying, wait a minute, if I got my back hurt, if I knew I had to, I wouldn't have came up for the illustration. And how we, and she thinking, wait a minute, hold me now. Wait, can we going to count? How we going to, oh, and then wait, this ain't the kind of thing that I, Jesus over there. So at some point we got to, they thinking, hold on, my lashes is coming out. Wait, this, I came to be cute at women's Bible study. I didn't think it was going to be no whole exercise. And the Bible said Jesus is preaching and they lay her at the feet of Jesus. It's so, look, let me tell you about knees. Go ahead. Let me tell you, go ahead for them knees. Now here it is. Not only must you stay connected to vision, but you have to stay connected to people who understand agreement. Because here's the thing. When we stepped back and we said, you got to get her from here to there, immediately the conversation started. It wasn't, well, how much am I getting paid for this? And am I going to get a prize for this? And who's going to recognize me for this? And will I get invited to the private lunch for this? All they were concerned about is, what do we need to do in order to get somebody we care about to the feet of Jesus? And the Bible says, how can two walk together unless they agree? But then it says, if two of you can agree on any matter, you shall have whatever it is that you say. Touch somebody and say, I need you to agree with me. I got some children. I got a marriage. I got a business. I got finances. I need somebody to agree that God is able to do anything but fail. You not healed yet. Help of y'all. Bible says they get her to Jesus, and Jesus says, your sins are forgiven. And we like, hold on. We didn't tow these people's roof up. We done stretched our knees and damaged our cartilage a little bit in order to get her in front of you, and you talking about her sins are forgiven? People in the crowd couldn't understand it because they were happy with Jesus, the miracle worker. They were happy with Jesus, genie in the lamp, where I run and pray and you give me whatever I want, but I don't have to submit my life to your authority and to your kingship. They were happy with the Jesus who worked miracles. But it was the message, the essence of the gospel, that was actually going to change his life. So Jesus said, I understood, I knew in my spirit. You know how your grandmama used to say, in my spirit is something about her, I just don't. He knew in his spirit what they were thinking. So he said, just so you will know, I have authority to forgive sins and heal. He said, take up your bed and walk. Didn't say he touched him. Didn't say he laid hands on him. At his word, he was immediately healed. So now this is where you get up right here. Y'all, come on, help up. But here's what I want you to see. Because sometimes when we're not the one in that position, we don't understand the benefit of even going through the motion. But I want you to notice where everybody is. They came to bring her to the feet of Jesus. But in bringing her, because sometimes the way to stay connected is not what you do for you, it's what you do for somebody else. So don't you think that when Jesus started passing out miracles, I don't even need him to say nothing to me. I just need to be in the vicinity of her, because whatever he does for her, then I receive the overflow of whatever God is doing, because I made a decision to stay connected, whatever it took. But it took vision. So do you see yourself better than where you are right now? Are you connected to people who see you better than where you are right now? Because people who don't have any vision for you will never help you get to where God wants you to go. The only reason they were able to move is because when they looked, they didn't see paralysis. They saw somebody walking and leaping and praising and dancing and worshiping. You laid out now, but when I see you, I don't see you for where you are. I see you for what God says you're going to be. they had to make a decision. We in or we out? Every day you wake up, when you pick up your cell phone, there's something on there that can make you disconnect. An email, a text message, a phone call, unless you just send it all to voicemail like me. Y'all pray my strength in the Lord. The goal of the enemy. He's not going to get everybody with sin. Because some people have gotten some victory in some things. All he has to do is keep you haughty enough to think that because you got victory, you don't have to be connected no more. That you can handle it on your own. But it was the connection to each one of these that actually brought deliverance for this person. So much so that everybody who even witnessed it was blessed. Because the last thing you have to stay connected to is action. Because faith without works is dead. So the Bible says that he walked them through this scenario, healed the man, forgave his sins. The man got up and walked. And everybody praised God because they recognized that he wasn't just a miracle worker, but indeed he really was the Messiah. And that if they stayed connected, whether it was through service, through ministry, through worship, through the word, through small groups, through relationship, because here's the truth of the matter. Every woman that's standing up here can say, I may not look like it, but I know what it's like to be laid out. Now, if I'm lying, you tell me. But everybody can say, I've dealt with something that laid me low, and I just faked it. I just came, and they said, how are you? I'm blessed. How are you? When we really knew that, God, if you don't do something about this, I don't know if I'm going to be able to hang on. Here's what I need you to do. Yes, we've been shut down. Yes, you all have been back for a minute. But there are some ladies who are still stretched out. You haven't seen them. You haven't heard from them. They can't come unless you go get them. And you might be the lady that stretched out yourself. And you need to just raise your hand and say, come get me. I need some help. Because people have experienced things and are still experiencing things. At the hotel, I was being checked in, and the girl who checked me in had a strong accent. I didn't think anything of it. And so wherever I go, I find a Target. Y'all pray for me. I have to know where the Target is. Because you just never know when you're going to need a good Target. And so I Googled, and there was a Super Target. And I said, well, let me go see this. What's in the Super Target that I can buy for only a two-day trip? Y'all pray for me. On the way back to the hotel, the driver said to me, he said, you know, the girl who connected us, who you know, called me for you, she's from Ukraine. And he said her whole family is in Ukraine. And she's standing at the desk mad saying, hi, may I help you? Because you don't know what people are actually struggling with. But you need somebody who was so connected to Jesus, because here's the thing. They knew where to take him. When I'm laid out, don't take me to the mall. I can get there by myself. Don't take me to the nail shop. You can take me to the spa, but take me after I get up. You need to be connected to people who can get you to God. Anybody ever needed somebody to pray for them? Anybody ever needed somebody to intercede for them? Because I've been trying to pray for myself, but God, the more I pray, the more my words get jumbled, and it seems like everything I've prayed for, you ain't done that yet. You need somebody to be able to call on. Somebody in your group who you're not afraid to be transparent, so you don't say, it's not my sister, it's not my husband, it's me, oh Lord. Standing in the need. So here's what I want to do. When you're first, your job is not hard. It's to encourage your heart, to inspire you to go through the rest of the semester, believing that your ladder shall be greater than your past. But for some of us, we gotta first let God change our posture. There are some people who you wear your heaviness like a mask. But tonight is your night to be able to let some stuff go. Because you've just been carrying it far too long. And God is still God. Still able. Just so you don't think, let me interrupt the servant. Get up. Oh, okay, back to the message. Just as quick as he did it for him, he can do it for you. But it requires us to stand before the Lord, as scripture says, naked and not ashamed. So all I want to do is pray. Y'all know the clock looking at me, I'm looking at the clock. Naked and not ashamed. So if that's you, just stand. I don't know, are we altering? We can alter? I love Texas. So if that's you, and you say, you know what, I need it. I need somebody to help me get to Jesus. We still going to be distant because I'm from California. But just meet me. How about you meet me in the aisle? How about we do that? Just come stand in the aisle, and we're going to pray and believe God. Naked and not ashamed. You can come closer if you want to. But I don't want no games. God is not too much. But like they saying, but I believe that God can do it again. Come on, ladies. I'm sorry. You can come closer or come down. Y'all were wonderful. Y'all stay right here if you want to. I'm going to get some glucosamine. Work on my knee game. Come on. You can come up a little bit. No shame at all. It's all right. Come on. I'm a backup so that y'all can come on. Come on. Make room for them. It's no shame. People make you feel like when you find yourself in that position, it's because you're weak. Because somehow you can't do it. There's nothing wrong with you. We all go through it, from the people who hold the mic. Come here, somebody come stand with her. We don't let no sister go through by herself. Put your hands on her. You need a place to cry. You need a place to say, oh my God, I'm so tired, I don't know what I'm going to do. If you see a sister near you and she look like she needs somebody to put her hands on her, just put your hand on her shoulder. Some of us don't like to be touched because all touches were not godly. But just get close to her and say, I'm here for you. Because scripture doesn't tell us how he got paralyzed. Right? And sometimes we end up paralyzed through no fault of our own. It's what our parents did. It's what other people did. It was us trusting people we shouldn't have trusted, loving people who didn't see the image of God in us and love us back the way we should have been loved, people who made promises and didn't keep them. And after a while, it just laid us out. But we are here tonight as a sign to the enemy that we're going to do whatever it takes, that you trying to disconnect me, you trying to break me. If I gotta scream, I'ma scream. If I gotta holler, I gotta holler. If I run, I'm gonna run. But I'ma do whatever it takes to make sure that I stay connected to God and make sure I stay connected to that which is godly. Come on, touch her, say, stay connected. Tell her, don't let go. Don't let go. Even on the road, tell her, don't let go. Don't let go. Gracious God, there's nobody like you in all the earth. Even those who are viewing us online, on your jobs, in your homes, nobody like you in all the earth. We are gathered here in this, your sanctuary, your holy place. God, you said if we called on you here, that you would meet us here. So Spirit of the living God, fall fresh right now. Your daughters are here, God, with their hands lifted up, with tears in their eyes and praise and worship on their lips. But God, on the inside, some situations have laid them out, God. I don't know, but you know. Move by your Spirit right now, God. And whatever my sister stands in need of, touch right now in the name of Jesus. If it's her marriage, touch, God. If it's children, touch, God. If it's in her body, heal, God. Lord, if it's in her mind, have your way. Satan, the Lord God, rebuke you. And we declare no weapon formed against her shall prosper. We speak victory over her life even now. If it's in her emotions, God, you are a regulator. Send your Spirit and regulate even now. Bring balance, God, where there is imbalance. Give her to know that she has some people who you strategically placed to carry her where she needs to be. Open her eyes that she might be able to see who you have placed, oh God. Take the taste from her mouth, from those who mean her no good. Block her ears so she won't hear the negative words that are spoken. Put a coal of fire on her tongue that she might speak only that which you have spoken over her. I pray for women burdened for ministry, God. Burdened for purpose, who know that there has to be more to their life than what they're living right now. Touch them and remind them tonight, God, that you are able to do anything but fail. Go into the deep places, God, because we don't want the word that's going to come in these Bible studies to fall on shallow ground. We need it to take root so our lives can be transformed. We need it to take root so we can be doers of the word and not hearers only. We need it to take root, oh God, so that we can bear fruit that is pleasing to you. So God, we release it right now. We release the burdens. We release the heaviness. We release the weight. We say, have your way, Lord. That if we knew how to fix it, it would have been fixed, God, but you take it. We can't handle it. But we trade our burdens for your strength, oh God. We trade our pain for your joy, oh God. We trade our heaviness for your gladness, oh God. We trade our confusion for your wisdom, oh God. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we thank you because we don't have to wait till the battle is over. We know that even while we're speaking, you're already answering. We know that even before we prayed, you had already heard us. We know that even before we came, you ordained this night for our lives. God, so we declare this our night of victory. We declare this our night of overcoming. We declare this our night of transformation. We declare this our night of power. We declare this day the first day of the rest of our lives. We thank you, Lord. And before we end our prayer, God, we slip our hands in the air. And with our own mouths, we tell you how much we love you. How much you're a wonderful God. You're an awesome God. You're an amazing God. even at home and online where you are, slip your hands up wherever you are and tell God how wonderful God is. Thank you for keeping. Thank you for providing. Thank you for doing what we thought could never be done. Thank you for allowing us to be in this place, always saturated by. Thank you for our pastors. Thank you for our church. Thank you for our groups. Thank you that we have a place to go and be authentic and transparent, and you meet us there and give us the change that we need. We love you, oh God. We love you, oh God. And we thank you for being God and for loving us enough to not leave us how you find us, but having mercy on us and healing us even in deep places. In Jesus' name, we thank you for it. And we believe you for it. And we claim it even now. And we say amen, amen, and amen. Can we hug? If you comfortable, come on, hug a sister. Say we connected, we connected. If she not comfortable, it's okay. Find somebody else, hug her, say we connected. We are connected. Can't never get rid of me now. Come on and hug her. Tell her she not by herself. We connected. And we gonna do whatever it takes to make sure we all win together. We connected. And we gonna do whatever it takes. That's right. Let her get it out if she need to get it out. It's all right. Everybody can't handle the isolation. Everybody can't hold it by themselves. So we thank you for release, oh God. We thank you that our tears are not in vain. Your word said you catch our tears in a bottle, and before it's over, you pour them out on us as joy. Which is why they say weeping may endure for a night, but come on, touch your sister. Say it's morning time. I don't care what it looked like outside. I don't care what your watch say. I don't care what your phone says. It's morning time. That we gonna have some joy before it's over. I don't know how God's gonna do it, but we gonna leap for joy before it's over. I'm gonna dance before it's over. I'm gonna run and shout before it's over. I'm gonna give God glory before it's over. As a matter of fact, I ain't gonna wait till I stop crying. I'm gonna run and leap and praise him with tears in my eyes. Even though I can't see it yet, I'm gonna still give him glory like it's already done. Whatever it takes, oh God. Whatever it takes, that's what we gonna do. To stay connected. Because Jesus says in John 15, I am the true vine. And sometimes we break our own hearts because we deal with false vines. But when you stay connected to the true vine, he says you can't help but to bear fruit. Is my mask over there? Give me my, I got 15 of them, so look in that bag. You can open it. There's some kind of mask in there. Some mask for every occasion. There go one right there by your hand, right there. Stop playing with me. You got your hand on it right there. Uh-huh. That's it. Y'all praying? Because sometimes just need a little extra. That's all right. Y'all pastors know me. Are we singing that? You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. No one else like you. Are great miracles so great. Help me sing it. You are great. You do. I can hear you. There's no one.
There is no one else like you.
Thank y'all. No one else?
There is no one else like
you. Beautiful. No one else. You are great and worthy, God. No one in the whole wide world. Searched all over and I couldn't find nobody. You are great.
You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you.
There's no one, no one.
There is no one else like
you. God, you're so great.
You are great.
You do
miracles so great.
No one else.
Thank you, Lord, for your miraculous hand on our lives, Father. We know that you are victorious in all things. So any woman who is feeling like that things are impossible, Father, I pray you would speak truth to her. That in your word it says that all things are possible by you, Lord. So I pray that we would continue to submit our concerns, our worries, Father God, our stress, our anxiety to you, Father, because we know that is not of you. It is not from you, Father. I pray that we would cast our cares on you because you care. You are a good, good Father. We love you, Lord, but we know that you way more. We can't outmatch your love. Any woman that is feeling overwhelmed right now, Lord Jesus, we know you've already met her where she is, Father. I pray that you would show yourself strong in her weakness. Where she is weak, Lord, you are strong. So I pray that every woman in this room will experience your love, your kindness, your strength that never ends. Great you are, Father. Holy you are, Father. Jesus' name. Amen. Ladies, what a great word on tonight. Give it up for Jackie. Y'all wasn't ready. I know you weren't. Y'all didn't know what Jackie would bring from California. Jackie, we want to say thank you so much for being sensitive what the Lord was putting on your heart, for loving women so much. It's clear. So thank you. Just what we needed, right, ladies? The Lord knew just what we needed. Ladies, she mentioned, Jackie mentioned, being connected, that it's important for us to be connected. I want to encourage you. There's women here that are not. There's women online who are not connected. And that's not what Christ has intended for us. That's not what he wants. So ladies, please get connected to our ladies small groups. We have them. You've been seeing it popping up on the screen over and over again. Small groups, ladies 35 and under, ladies 35 and over. We have them available for you. So I encourage you to get connected. I know a woman may have hurt you. You might be that woman saying, I don't do women. Y'all, I used to be her. I had a lot, y'all Pastor Amanda, I had a lot of close male friends growing up. Two big brothers, cousins. I was the home girl. That was me. And it might be you too, but he wants you connected with women. Don't be afraid to get connected and to open your heart to those relationships. So there's ladies right now who want you in their group. And so if you're not in one yet, I want those to pop up. There they are. Look. Get connected to a group. If you have already signed up, you know where you're meeting. So make sure that you don't miss out on that opportunity to get to know ladies, grow together, carry each other's burdens. That's what God has called us to do. Some of us over here walking alone. That's not what God wants. Jesus wasn't walking alone, and we think we can walk alone. Okay, I'm gonna stop. So I encourage you again to get connected, ladies. If you need to talk to one of us, me, Denisha, Millicent, someone, we will be waiting up here to talk to y'all about what group you can get in. We're here. There's other ladies. If you're part of the women's ministry, make sure that you come up. Lisa, y'all come up to the front. Be ready. Prayer team, ladies, make sure you're ready too, because ladies might come up to the front and be asking for prayer as well. So I just want everybody to be ready. Okay? All right. Have a wonderful night, a wonderful weekend. I hope and pray that we see y'all on church this Saturday or Sunday at one of our campuses in the house. But that's my last. I'm going to say connection one more time. Y'all say connection. All right. Get connected, ladies, with another lady. See you later. Have a good night.